I remember that book. I miss being able to read books like those from our childhood.
There isn't an age limit on these books. Anyone can read them, even if they are children's books.
It's sad that many kids around our community don't have access to storybooks.
In fact, that's what today's show is about. Our school's SCCLA, with the help of other clubs, are setting up little libraries to provide books for kids in the community.
That sounds very cool. Let's go to Chloe with today's top story to learn more about these little libraries.
This year, our school's FCCLA is sponsoring the creation of little libraries. We are reusing newspaper boxes from the Lakeland Ledger and transforming them into miniature bookshops. They will go out in the streets for the public to take a book and leave a book. Many departments around our school, such as NJHS, Video Production, Student Government, and FCCLA, are painting these boxes.
We came up with the project because a bunch of students couldn't take library books home, or kids couldn't, so this way they can trade and take books home and read them.
We've used some boxes that we got from the Ledger, and we decorated them, and we're in the process of placing them in different locations where students go, like to Infinity, hopefully. We have one going to a dance studio. We're looking to have one go into the hospital, the new children's hospital. And we're just trying to get books out there for young people to be able to take and read. Sometimes they don't take a library book out, or their parents don't want them to because they never return them. This way you don't have to return it. We're going to be putting new books in all the time, a lot of different genres. So you can just go to one of those locations and take a book and keep it and read it and hopefully enjoy it.
I think it was important for me to work on it because everyone gets to read a book whenever it's all finished, and I just really love reading, so I want everybody to read.
I went to work on the little library because I love reading books, and I think other people would love to use their imagination to bring to life a book.
I like to do arts and crafts, so when spray painting the box, that was my favorite part. And I like to know that everyone gets to read and gets to use their imagination.
I'm just happy that people can get a book for free and read it, and then return it and someone else can read it.
I thought it would be awesome. It's also a really fun experiment to do and see all these people be happy because now they can read at home instead of having to do it at school.
Next time you're out in Lakeland, take time to stop by one of these little libraries and grab a book. Chloe Lanham, TSC News.
Who's the author of that book?
Dr. Seuss. He was my favorite author as a kid.
Oh, most of my childhood books were in my Roald Dahl.
There are many children's authors like R.L. Stein, Eric Carle, and Judy Blume.
Let's head on over to today's Brain Strain with Dallas to learn more about children's authors.
Everyone has a favorite story they remember from childhood, whether it's The Pokey Little Puppy, The Tales of Peter Rabbit, or Stuart Little. Children's books opened our imaginations and took us to exciting places. But which author takes the prize of favorite children's author on Ranker.com? Your choices are A, Dr. Seuss, whose classics Cat in the Hat and Oh, the Places You'll Go have delighted little ones since the 1960s. B, J.K. Rowling, the author of Harry Potter series, whose net worth is over $1 billion. C, Roald Dahl, the author of such classics as Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory and Matilda, has sold over 10.4 million books. Or D. C.S. Lewis, whose series The Chronicles of Narnia has sold over 100 million copies in 47 languages. Ready, set, strain that brain! The answer is C. Roald Dahl. Did you know Dahl invented more than 500 new words and character names? Did you get the answer right? If you don't agree, go to Ranker.com and vote to get your favorite author on the top of the list. Dallas Gray, TSC News.
We have a lot of activities going on at LG next week.
It's time to go to Chelsea with today's Shark Scoop to learn more.
Happy Friday, Sharks. I'm Chelsea, and here are the final announcements for the week.
Monday is the final day to bring in new socks for the National Junior Honor Society Socktober Drive. Remember, the first period class who brings in the most new socks wins a donut party. Flag football tournament sign-up forms are available from Ms. Keene. The first 8 teams to get all players' forms turned in will be the 8 teams to play in the tournament. This tournament will be held on Tuesday, November 27th from 4:15 until 6 p.m. All students must have their own rides home from this event. The winning team will play our teacher team in the final game of the tournament.
Now, let's head over to Nate for a special report in the sports zone.
It's an exciting time for LG Sports.
Our girls basketball team won their final regular season game against Sparta, and after outscoring Kathleen, Lakeland Highlands, Rochelle, Sleepy Hill, and Lon Childs earned the title of undefeated again this year. In fact, the 8th grade members of the team have been undefeated all three of their years in middle school.
To be undefeated from my 6th grade year to my 8th grade year is a great accomplishment because our team has worked hard for it.
I feel that we've grown as a family and a team.
I feel that over the years that our basketball family has become stronger and closer.
Congratulations to all team members. Nate Bath, TSZ News.
Let's Light Up LG. The Light Up Spirit Bracelets are now available in the main office for $5 each. They come in three colors, garnet, gold, and blue. Make sure to get yours before they sell out. This week's word of the week has been refurbished. It's a verb that means to renovate or redecorate something.
I hope everyone has an amazing weekend. Chelsea Carrasco, TSC News.
I need to go home and grab a book for the little libraries.
What book are you going to donate?
I'm going to donate Goodnight Moon because it used to be my favorite bedtime story.
I'm going to donate Horton Hears a Who because it teaches you how to be a good listener.
To learn what book the Sharks would donate, let's go to Briley with today's Hot Topic.
The first little library was built in 2009 by Todd Bull. According to littlefreelibraries.org, he designed a wooden container filled with books as a tribute to his mother. By November 2016, Little Libraries grew to over 50,000 worldwide. Today's Hot Topic question is, which book would you donate to a little library?
I would donate The Three Little Pigs because I read that book a lot when I was younger.
I would donate Taken by a T-Rex because it's one of the most creative, romantic novels I have ever read.
I would donate Magic Tree House because it's really fun and interesting to read.
I would donate Geronimo Stilton because I think it's a really good series and I like the mystery involved in it.
I would donate a Dr. Seuss book because they're fun and amusing.
I would donate Pete the Cat because it teaches kids to love diversity.
I would donate Wonder because it teaches kids to be nice to each other.
I would give kids the Marvel Action series because it gives kids an adventure.
I would donate a Diary of a Wimpy Kid book because they like show the problems of middle school and stuff like that and what like teenage kids go through.
Did you know little libraries can be found in 80 other countries? And soon, there will be more here in Lakeland when our little libraries get delivered to their new homes. Briley McDonald, TSC News.
Thanks to our schools, SCCLA, with the help of other clubs, for working so hard on the little libraries.
They will definitely benefit those in need in our community.
Make sure to watch TSC News next week for shows about Halloween, the importance of school IDs, and Lakeland's best barbecue.
I'm Ryla.
And I'm Ava. Have a wonderful weekend, Sharks.